First and foremost, I'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory unto the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, Makakodash. Double honor to the apostles and the elders, Adul, Vala, Great Millstone. Peace and salutation to the Akiyam, all the portions, gospel, and sincerity and truth. I say shalom to you, humble and sincere sisters out there as well. This is so being titled Drunkenness and Revelings. You understand? Drunkenness and revelings, you know, and it's basically, you know, I just wanted to bring out a few precepts and, you know, just get into the definition of these words, you understand, and really understand how we ought to carry about ourselves as Israelites, you know, when you call yourself an Israelite, a Hebrew Israelite, you know. What it really means, you know, the Lord, they talk about being separate from this world, being separate from the people of this world, and, you know, and not physical things, on a spiritual level, obviously, because if you want to separate yourself from them, you might have to go and live on the moon. Alright, just gonna kick it off in Galatians chapter 5, no? It's a lot. Yeah, Galatians 5 verse 20, I'll start at verse 19. It's, you know, the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envyings, murders, drunkenness, and revelings, and such like. Right? It says, and such like. I just want to get the definition of these words here. Start with drunkenness.
Strong's G, 3178. Methe. Methe.
Right, it's intoxication, drunkenness, wine, perhaps any intoxicating drink. You know, a lot of these Christians, you know, seeing this here, a lot of these Christians just try to get out to is as if you can't drink no kind of alcohol, and that's true. Because remember, I wish I was a wine bibber, and you know, I thought a precept was basically saying, I wonder if it. I believe it was the third hour of the day, and I genuinely barely can remember, but I don't know which apostle it was or if it was a group of them, but they were drinking and people were saying basically it's only the third hour of the day and they've already begun to drink, you know. So it is not even if the Passover you had to drink wine, so it's not saying to not drink alcohol whatsoever. But obviously, you know, moderation, right? I want to get a definition of the word revelings.
Strong's G, 2970. Komos. Komos.
It's a revel, carousel, a nocturnal and riotous procession of half-drunken and frolicsome fellows who after supper parade through the streets with torches and music in honor of Bacchus or some other deity, and sing and play before houses of male and female friends, hence used generally of feasts and drinking parties that are protracted till late at night and indulge in revelry. Right, it's a carousel, as if letting loose, reveling, rioting. Right, and I also want to look up with a such like, you know, tough like, yeah.
Strong's G, 3664, Hamoyas.
Say like, similar, resembling. So it's envyings, murders, drunkenness, revelings, you know, and such like. So resembling a reveling, resembling drunkenness, you understand? and such like. You look at this holiday that we celebrate, well, not we, but that the people of Trinidad celebrate Carnival, right? That definition of revelings, it basically describe Carnival, right? Getting drunk, going in the streets, singing, partying, parading, right? Rioting, you know? And that is literally basically Carnival. Even if you was to go and look at these parties, these parties in these clubs and these Zessa parties and all these things, and you see the way they carry about themselves, that is what reveling is, right? Men and women together, they dry humping each other, you know, alcohol, everybody drunk, having sex, you understand, partaking and smoking cigarette, popping pills, you understand, vaping, all these things in the midst, right? That is what reveling is. And we's not to partake in them kind of thing. You know, so you use your head, right? Use your head. Be circumspect. Don't put yourself in a situation to anger the Most High. And you yourself, don't put yourself in a tempting situation. Right? Because let me say you want to go out in a club. You go in this club, cigarette smoking all over the place. You inhaling cigarettes, smoke. It's all manner alcohol, women, right? Everybody there just reveling, right? You drinking, you get intoxicated, right? You tipsy, somebody handing you a cigarette, right? You quit cigarette, you quit smoking some years now, right? But you have no, you're losing that cognitive function, you're losing that prefrontal cortex, you understand? You're losing that decision making ability. You take the cigarette and you begin to smoke, right? Trip off your Obashim Yahushai, right? Or this woman there, you know, maybe she or she husband there, or whatever, you know that, right? She get a drink, she buy a drink, all the drinking, you buy a drink, she buy a drink, whatever the case is, understand? Basically, you get drunk, right? This woman seduce you, you have sex with she, you knew she had a husband, you did it anyways. Because why? You're too drunk. You understand? You're too drunk to make a proper decision. And you putting yourself in a situation like that now cause you to sin. Now cause death to come upon you. Right? The wages of sin is death. You understand? Look at that scene with Sakari. Look at what they did. Right? On a solemn feast day. Right? Look at what they did. That was a reveling, right? Dealing with strippers. It's dealing with strippers on a solemn day. You understand? In the midst. As if the Passover is some big party. You understand? As if it's a big lime. Right, and hey, nobody ain't saying you had to be a monk. You understand? Nobody in sin be a monk and just sit down and meditate and eat vegetables, you understand? And just be a square, right? And don't do anything. I know what we're saying. But you gotta understand. It's balance. You gotta understand that balance. In Romans 13, verse 13, they say, let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envying. You look up the word here for chambering.
Strong's G 2845. Coite.
It's a place for lying down, resting, sleeping in a bed, couch, marriage, bed of adultery, cohabitation, whether lawful or unlawful sexual intercourse, right? So it's let us walk honestly as in the day, right? To be of light, not in rioting and drunkenness and chambering and wantonness and strife and envying, right? It says, but put ye on the Lord Yahushua and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof, right? Because you ought to remember too, We in the last days. Now is not the time to be focusing on carnal things, to be focusing on temporal things. Now is the time to put all your trust in Yahweh Hashem Yahushai and do the will of the Heavenly Father even more. Even more in these times. You understand? And I'll give an example, like if you see a brothel, right? A whole house, right? As you refer to it in Trinidad. Or you could call it a strip club, or, right? But the word for it is brothel. If a man is burning, right? If a man is burning in heat or whatever the case is, and he wanna go in a brothel and do eating, by all means go ahead, right? There's no law against it. There's no sin committed. You're in your liberty to do so, right? Go right ahead. Do your thing in private. But you can't wanna be. Imagine being in a whole house every single day, right? That shows a man with no stability. That shows a man that has no control, no strength. A man that has not the ability to rule over his own spirit. You understand? That is what that shows. A man that you need to go into this place every single day. Right? Or every single week. Or as you get, you know, you have your job, as you get paid, that the first place you run into. That shows weakness. That you as a man can't control yourself. Right? The scripture says to be temperate. You know, I want to look up it. Let me see if I can get that word here. I just want to get the definition of the word.
Strong's G, 1467. Ekratuamai.
They say to be self-controlled, continent, to exhibit self-government, conduct oneself temperately. In a figure drawn from athletes who, in preparing themselves for the game, abstain from unwholesome food, wine, and sexual indulgence. Right? Because back then in the ancient world, as it say, as the definition say, yeah, right, coming up to a big game or the Olympics, whatever the case was, athletes would abstain from unhealthy food, they would abstain from alcohol, they would abstain from sex with women. Even I believe it was Mike Tyson said he used to do that as well. A lot of athletes of our time practice nofap as well during their on season, right, and coming up to games or whatever. They would store up that sexual energy, you understand? And they would abstain from alcohol, from sex, from all these carnal pleasures, and be single-minded, everything into winning, right? And what verse 25 say, every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate, has that control, but they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we are incorruptible. So they're doing it for nothing, right? They trying to get as fast as they could to run 100 meters and win a gold medal, and that is where it's stopping for them. But the crown we trying to obtain is a crown of infinity, of eternal, you understand, of everlasting, forever. That's what we want. That's what we're running after. Forever. Right? So you need to be temperate. You need to have control over your emotions, over your desires, over yourself. Right? Like alcohol. Sure, you might get drunk time to time, right? You know, you're in a feast with the brothers, whoever. You get a little intoxicated, whatever the case is, you're with family. But do you think it is a good idea to be drunk every single day? Do you think it's a good idea to be high out of your mind, right? Every single living day. No. No, the answer is no. Moderation. You're not going to be drunk every single day. You're not going to eat wheat brownies every single day. You're not going to be going in a whole house to have sex every single day. Right? And you don't have to be so. You don't have to be. It could be something as simple as playing a video game. You are not going to play video games every single day, 24 hours of the day. You're not going to be on the social media the majority of your day. You understand? Because when are you going to give Yahweh Hashem your shy time? Right? Your main priority should be to the Most High, and then everything else should come after. And if something is blocking you from giving your all, then it needs to be removed from your life. Right, then it's like if going off topic and I know going all over the place. In 1 John chapter 2 verse 16, it says, "For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world." Right, verse 15, "Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him." Right? Really ask yourself where you're going. Right? Think about it. Yeah, you gotta be separate from these people. You can't be a man of the Lord, right? And you in some Zessa party balling six and pretending you got a gun in your hand and dancing and making a fool of yourself, right? Because if you go in there around these people and you getting on like them, and then they see you in a garment on the street, them gonna say who he could possibly preach to. He was doing the same thing we was doing last night, balling six and getting on like a dumb nigga. You understand? You have to be an example. You have to set an example. Not just when the garment on, right? But it's more so when the garment is off, when you're living your everyday life. You need to set an example. You need to be different from these people. And when them watch you, them supposed to know, hey, this is a man of the Lord. This is what a man of the Lord, this is how a man of the Lord operates. Right? You're supposed to see that separation, that difference between you and these people. It's saying that you love not the world, right? Don't partake in their feasts. Don't partake in their parties. Right? And don't try to mimic their ways. Their ways are of the devil. But more so mimic the ways of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. In 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 17, say, "Wherefore come out from among them and be ye separate, say the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you." Come out from among them, from among these people. You understand? Being drunk all the damn time, being high out your mind all the damn time, party every single day, right? Getting drunk, falling on the ground, smoking weed, smoking cigarette, right? Popping pills and that whole lifestyle that does not represent this truth. You understand? That doesn't represent this truth. That's how them dumb niggas just get on, right? That's how the people of this world just get on. That's how they scare about themselves like beasts. Right? Remember, the breath of life is not within them. They are dead. And that's how a live dead person does act. No sense. You understand? That's somebody I know. Hey, this man was a good athlete. You understand? This man was a terrific athlete. Hey, fast forward some years, hey, smoking cigarettes every day, smoking weed every day, drunk every day, right? He not even a quarter as good as he was before. He not even 5% as good as he was before. He's a complete failure. Gave up everything he could have received to be a fool, to smoke drugs, you understand, to be an alcoholic, We as men of the Lord, we are not to be alcoholics. Sure, we could indulge in wine. Sure, you could drink alcohol. But you don't want to be an alcoholic. See, you'd say to be temperate, to have self-control. You don't want to be drunk all the damn time. Your focus needs to be on Yahobashim Yoshai, not on getting high. Get high off the spirit. This will be my last precept. Alrighty, Philippians chapter 4 verse 5, it say, let your moderation be known unto all men, the Lord is at hand, right? Look up the definition of this word.
Strong's G, 1933. Epi case.
It is seeming suitable, equitable, fair, mild, gentle. You understand? So these things, right? When you drinking, you know what? Let just get away from drinking. Anything to in this world. Anytime it becomes an addiction, anytime it becomes habit, right? You need to cut it out. Like, let's say drinking, right? If you know that you can't hold your liquor, if you know that if you take one shot, you're gonna wanna take two and four and eight, it's best to stay away from it. Right? Like for me, TikTok is something that does take my attention, and I realize that, so you know what I do? I try to stay away from it. You know? I try to stay away from it because I know me continuing to watch it is me feeding that demon, making it stronger, making the addiction grow, right? And then when you're addicted to TikTok or you're addicted to Twitter or Instagram, whatever the case is, while you're wasting time on this app, you are away from your Bashem, your Shai, right? Because if you really think about it, if you're doing something towards this truth, you're wasting time. You understand? So that just exactly where it is. This will be my last precept, and a salakia for just jumping all over the place. Yeah, but you flow with the spirit. Galatians chapter 5 verse 13. It says, for brethren ye have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. Yeah, the sound so a. Use not this liberty, because use not this freedom for an occasion to be wicked, for an occasion to be carnal, for an occasion to be weak. You do not need to go in a brothel every single week. You understand? Not every time you pay, you need to go and deal with a woman. No. Alright? No. You don't need to get drunk every time you drink. Right? And you're vomiting on yourself and thing, you don't need to get to that state every single time. You don't need to be distracted by social media, or by video games, or by TV show, movies, to the point that you just sit down there for hours wasting time. You don't. Alright? You know, so it's, as I say, it's a lack effort for this video going all over the place. But you know, I hope the message reached, right? I hope it was edifying that, hey, Yahobashim Yahushai is the main thing that we need to be studying right now. You understand? And drunkenness, revelings, being of this world, you understand? Hey, being drunk, not just off of real alcohol, but being drunk off of the philosophies of this wicked-ass kingdom, you know, to stay away from that. To stay away from these people, you understand? Because they will lead you astray. To stay away from... It don't make sense going in these clubs. You understand? Excessively. You understand? It don't make sense to excessively go into these clubs and lime around these people. Right? Because look at Solomon, right? I don't even have to go into it for men to understand why I say that. Look at King Solomon. Right? How he was led astray. Right, you know, not to be distracted, but focus on Yahweh Shemir Shai. And with that, hope this lesson was edifying, giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, Bashem Makakodash, Shalom.